Hello children, welcome back to our online classes once more. Today we are going to start with a poem, A Legend of the Northland by Phoebe Cary. Phoebe Cary was an American poetess, and we find a very beautiful story, a story with a moral, that is of an old lady who angered Saint Peter because of her greed. The old lady was so greedy that she denied Saint Peter from food, and Saint Peter became so angry that he cursed her, and she suffered a very bad transformation. She became a woodpecker, and she was pecking for food, searching for food for the rest of her life. Now this poem is a legend. Legend in the sense it is a traditional story, and this poem, this legend has been shared with you all in the form of a ballad. What is a ballad? A ballad is a story narrated in short stanzas. A ballad is a story narrated in short stanzas, each stanza comprising four lines. There are 16 stanzas in this poem that will tell us the story. And ballads are also part of folk culture or popular culture that are passed on orally from generation to generation. Now let us begin the poem. Away, away in the Northland, where the hours of the day are few and the nights are so long in winter that they cannot sleep them through. Now in Northland, very close to the poles, the hours of the day hours are very less. Nights are very long. They are so long, so long that it is not possible to continue sleeping throughout the night. If nights are very long, we cannot sleep on and on and on. So they cannot sleep them through. The hours, the night hours, the dark hours are very long. The day hours are very few. Where they harness the swift reindeer to the sledges when it snows, and the children look like bears, cubs in their funny furry clothes. The harness means they join the swift reindeer to the sledges. They join the swift reindeer to the sledges. Reindeer is a popular animal in the north, and when it snows, they move in sledges. And children, they look like bears, cubs. They are so means cute and cuddly because they wear the furry clothes that time. In winter, they wear the furry clothes, and all the time, more or less all the time, they are wearing furry, funny clothes. They tell them a curious story. They tell them a curious story. Means the people tell the children a curious story. I don't believe it's true, and yet you may learn a lesson. If I tell the tale to you, if I tell the story to you, you may learn a lesson from the story. Once when the good Saint Peter lived in the world below and walked about it preaching, just as he did, you know. When good Saint Peter, disciple of Lord Christ, when he was living in the world below, he was moving here and there. Preaching means spreading the gospel, spreading the prayers, spreading the teachings of Jesus. Just as he did, as he was doing it every day, he was moving here and there, spreading the teachings of Jesus Christ. He came to the door of a cottage and traveling round the earth, where a little woman was making cakes and baking them on the hearth. Now he came to the door of a cottage, of a house, of a small hut he came, while he was moving here and there, and a little woman was making cakes and baking them on the hearth, on the fireplace. And being faint with fasting, who was faint with fasting? Saint Peter. For the day was almost done. He asked her from her store of cakes to give him a single one. He was feeling faint with fasting and the day was almost over. So he asked her from her store of cakes, from her collection of cakes, he requested her to give him a small piece, a single one. So she made a very little cake, but as it baking lay, she looked at it and thought it seemed too large to give away. As the woman was making a very little cake for Saint Peter, she looked back at it and thought that it was too large, too big to give away. Therefore, she needed another. She again pressed the dough and made a still smaller one. But it looked, when she turned it over, as large as the first had done. Means she tried to reduce the size and make a smaller one in size, in proportion, but when she turned it over, it appeared to be as large as the previous one. Then she took a tiny scrap of dough and rolled it flat and baked it thin as a wafer, but still she couldn't part with that. She took a small tiny bit of dough and started rolling and rolling it flat and baked it thin. It was almost thin as a wafer, but still she couldn't part with that. For she said, "My cakes that seem too small when I eat of them myself are yet too large to give away." So she put them on the shelf. The cakes seem too small when she consumes, when she eats herself. Yet the same cake seems too large to give away. And with all these thoughts in mind, she put the cakes back on the shelf. Then the good Saint Peter grew angry, for he was hungry and faint, and surely such a woman was enough to provoke a saint. The good Saint Peter became very angry, for he was hungry and almost fainting, and surely such a woman, means anybody will be angry with such a woman who was enough to provoke, means a kind of, you know, a kind of, you are trying to instigate will be a very difficult word for you to understand. You are trying to anger a saint. A saint has got lot of peace in his mind. But if you are trying to provoke, if you are trying to instigate or anger a saint, that means you are the worst person. Means a saint cannot easily get angry, isn't it? So you are the worst person. And he said, "You are far too selfish to dwell in a human form, to have both food and shelter and fire to keep you warm." And he said that you are worthless. You are too selfish, you know. To dwell means to live in a human form. And you have both food and shelter and fire to keep you warm. These things are not at all meant for you. They are meant for human beings. But you are far too selfish. Now you shall build as the birds do and shall get your scanty food by boring and boring and boring all day in the hard, dry wood. So he cursed him. What did he say? That you shall build as the birds now do and shall get your little food by boring and boring, by pecking and pecking and pecking all day in the hard, dry wood. Then up she went through the chimney, never speaking a word, and out of the top flew a woodpecker, for she was changed to a bird. Now that old woman was changed to a bird, a woodpecker. She had a scarlet cap on her head, a red cap on her head, but that was left the same. But all the rest of her clothes were burned black as a coal in the flame. So a woodpecker's color is black. So the rest of the clothes were burned as black as coal. And every country school boy has seen her in the wood where she lives in the trees till this day, boring and boring for food. So this is a lovely poem. It shares a beautiful lesson with us, that is, we should not be selfish because we are all human beings. We are blessed with food and shelter and fire to keep us warm and happy. So we should not be selfish and we should be really human and godly with all goodness with us, inside us all the time. That's all. I'll be sharing this thing, your literary device also.